Let's talk about macros in Excel. If you're familiar with Excel macros, you know that they help you automate tasks. Now you can record these yourself, or if you want more complex macros, for example, macros that are based on some type of logic, you can write these out yourself in the VBA editor in Excel. Now the language you write your code in is Visual Basic for Applications. Now where does OfficeScript fit in the picture? What's the difference with VBA? Is OfficeScript here to replace VBA? Well, let's take a look at the facts first. What they have in common is this. Both VBA and OfficeScript allow you to automate your tasks. Now, the target group for both are officially non-programmers, so business users, although it's probably easier for programmers to join the party. Now, the main difference is that VBA is for desktop applications and not for the web. So it can't be used in Excel on the web or if you use Excel in Teams. OfficeScript is currently for the web. It works in Teams as well since Teams uses the web technology. And it will probably be for desktop as well in the future. So as you can see, one of them has a brighter future. Now let's take a look at a VBA example. So here is a quick macro I created earlier. It creates this chart based on this dataset. Now I made it also dynamic so that if the dataset is larger or smaller, the chart size automatically adjusts. Now this is something I made a video about some time ago. I'm gonna add the link to the description of the video. Check it out if you wanna know how this is done. Now just to show you that this works, I'm gonna jump to the Finance tab, go to View, Macros, View Macros. The macro is Create Chart. Let's just run it. That automatically inserts the chart. This part of my task is made automatically. I don't need to go and insert this chart or adjust the colors every time I need to do this. I just have to run my macro. Now, another thing you can do in VBA is to assign your macros to objects. So instead of going and looking for the macro from the menu here, I can go to the Insert tab and I can insert any shape that I want or a button and assign that macro to it. So I could call this Insert Chart and just right mouse click on it, assign macro, find the macro, it's called Create Chart, and then click on OK. And now I can just click on this and it inserts the chart. If you have a sheet and then you have different data sets and you want to assign your macro to a button, you can do that. You just click on Insert Chart and you get it inserted. Here's a more complex VBA solution. So this one is a monthly sales reporting data preparation tool where you get to import data from different files. You get to automatically create reports and then create CSV files that you can upload to other applications. Now this one is more complex. The code behind this is something that can't be recorded with a macro recorder. So unlike the example that we saw before, which can be recorded with a macro recorder and then we can easily tweak it, this one has a lot of if statements, it has a lot of looping, things that the macro recorder can't do. So for example, this part where we import the cells, when I click on this button, I get to browse for my file. So let's say I want to import, let's go with this one, I click on open. It basically does something similar to Power Query. It's going to import my data here, and then I can create reports and then generate CSV files and so on. So the code here is more complex. If I bring up the Visual Basic Editor, which we can do with Alt F11, this is one of the modules, that's the import one. And you can see we have a lot of variables here that we're declaring and error handling and so on, right? So all of this is things that you program, although you can use the macro recorder to pick up parts of this code, but then you have to incorporate it in this additional code that you're writing. Now, in case you're interested how to write VBA or to learn VBA, I have a complete course and I'm gonna add the link to the description below this video. But now let's take a look at OfficeScript. How does that look? To use OfficeScript, first go to office.com, log in, and because I'm using OfficeScript in Excel, I'm gonna go to Excel and open a blank workbook. Now you can also use an existing workbook and create your script based on that. In this case, we're just gonna open a blank workbook and go to the Automate tab. So this is where you can record your actions, you can view your scripts, you can take a look at some sample scripts and so on. Now, if you don't see the Automate tab, That's either because your admin has deactivated this feature for you, or you don't have a business or enterprise account. Notice, just like in Excel, we have a macro recorder. This is automatically going to generate your code for you based on your actions. Now, it's not as clever to pick up everything like the VBA recorder, although I have to say the VBA recorder also doesn't pick up everything, but it's a bit more complete than this one, but that's because Office Scripts is newer. It's going to get better with future updates. The fact that you can record your actions here makes it easier for business users to start to learn this code. So let's just do something simple. I'm just going to record actions here just to see how this part looks like. It tells me that it's recording, and let's say my actions are usually to add a title here and a subtitle. And I want this to be, let's say, bold. I want it to be a different color, and let's also make it bigger. And let's just highlight this and add a border. Okay, so notice as I'm doing all these actions, everything is being recorded here. I'm going to stop the recording. We can take a closer look at the script. The script was generated. Just let's click on this and rename this to formatting. Okay, so if we edit the script, we can actually see the code that was generated here. The great thing about this is that we get comments automatically inserted for us. So here we can see that the range A1 to A2 was set to this. Now, here's a difference to anyone who knows VBA is that it automatically added this type of array syntax to this. So it didn't do one cell at a time. It actually did both of them together. Then it changed the font here and added the rest of the formatting. So notice here, we also have curly brackets, and in VBA where I had dim, where I was declaring variables, here we have let, and you can also use var. So the code here is called TypeScript, and this is a subset of JavaScript. Now the macro recorder records in TypeScript, but you can also write JavaScript in here if you're familiar with JavaScript. Another difference to VBA here is that my script is saved in a separate file to this file. This means I can easily use it with any other files. I can, of course, connect it to this file as well. So if I know that I have this file and it needs that code, I can go to options here under sharing. I can share this so that anyone who has access to this workbook is going to be able to view the script. But I don't necessarily need to bind this to this file. Now, just to make sure that this script runs, I'm going to go to another sheet and I'm going to run my script, and it should add a title and subtitle with my formatting to this. Now, this means that I can open any other file, because now when I go to the Automate tab, I can see my code in here. I can open any file and I can run this code. The script is saved as a separate file in my OneDrive folder. I can also share this code with others in the organization. Now, what about looping, if statements, and more complex code? Well, you can do all that in Office Scripts. It's just that the way you write these and the way some of these objects behave is going to be different. So for example, here, notice we do a let selected sheet equals workbook.getActiveWorksheet. Now, the selection has to be done in Office Scripts, whereas in VBA, you don't necessarily need to select a sheet, because if you don't, by default, it assumes the active sheet. Here, you actually have to make that selection. Now, another major difference is this one here. So let's say I want to do something simple. I just want to get the address of cell A1. So first, we've already defined a selected sheet is the active sheet, right? So I'm going to use that. I'll go with selected sheet. Now, as I'm typing, I get IntelliSense. I'm going to press tab to accept it. Selected sheet dot, I'm going to go with get cell, and the cell that I want, let's open bracket, do 1, 1. This is row number, column number, right? So I'm going to go 1 for row number, 1 for column number, dot, now let's do get address, and open close bracket. So now let's also assign this to something. I'll call this let my ad, right? So from my address equals this. Now, to test what we get, we can use console. So that's the way of debugging. So console.log, open bracket, and let's go with my ad. So let's just go to another sheet so that we can see the rest of the macro. I'm going to run this. I'm going to get a title subtitle. And now I get sheet 3 B2. Is that what I wanted? I got cell 1-1, row 1, column 1. 1-1 is B2. This is a major difference between Office Scripts and VBA, because Office Scripts is zero-based. So cell 0-0, let's just run this again. Just going to overwrite these, is A1. Okay, so that, I'm sure, is going to get some time to get used to. Now, this, of course, is a very simple script. In the next video, we're actually going to create a column chart using dynamic ranges, right? So we're going to get the macro recorder to record it for us, and then we're going to make a slight adjustment to it to make it dynamic. If you want to learn more about Office Scripts, make sure that you check out next week's video. Now, remember, when we did VBA, I also inserted objects and I assigned macros to it. That's something we can't yet do in Office Script. So I can't insert an object and assign a script to it, at least not yet. Another thing we can't do is to have pop-up dialog boxes and pop message boxes and so on. And we can't also use events. So if you're familiar with VBA, you can use events. For example, if a sheet is selected, a macro should run automatically. If you select a cell, if you change a cell's value, a macro is executed automatically. That's something that we can't currently do in Office Scripts. But something that we can do in Office Scripts, which is amazing, is that we can use Power Automate to run our script. So we don't even have to have Excel open to run a script. We can use Power Automate based on a trigger. The trigger can be a special time. It can be because we receive an Outlook email. It can be because we select certain rows in another Excel file. All of those can be triggers in Power Automate. So where does that leave us? Will Office Scripts replace VBA? I think eventually yes, but not in the short run. And as we know, the short run can be quite long for Microsoft products. A lot of companies use Excel on desktop. A lot of companies will not have Office 365. A lot of companies already have more complex VBA solutions that they can't replace with Office Scripts because it's not as advanced. So I think we can safely assume that VBA will still be valid for at least the next 10 years, and probably much longer than that. What's your take on this? Let me know in the comments below. I hope this video gave you a better understanding of what Office Scripts is all about. I'm really excited about Office Scripts. It's new, it's something we can all learn together. It's safe to say that you can expect future Office Scripts videos as I learn more about it. So hit that subscribe if you aren't subscribed. Give this video a like. Thank you for being here, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.